Chari Ganesan, your grade 9 computer science teacher. Today in this class we are going to learn what is computer system and operating system and a little bit basic of the Microsoft Word. Let's get into the chapter computer system. So before what is the definition of the computer, let's just recap that. It is an electronic device which can enter the data and store the data and give the process the data and give the final output to you. Okay, whatever you are typing in the keyboard, it is called the data. Okay, and it will be, once you type the data, it will be stored in the computer memory. In the computer memory, it has set of instruction to be performed on the particular data. Once it is performed, the final information, the output, will be displayed in your monitor. Okay, so to know into detail, we will see the picture over here. This is the flowchart of your computer system. First one, if you see, the rectangle box is input device. This is where you will be having the keyboard and you will be giving your data, that is, and it will be, second one is called CPU, central processing unit, and third one is output device. Okay, so in the CPU, brain of the computer, you might say it is a brain of computer. In the CPU, it has three different units. One is control unit, another one is arithmetic and logic unit, and third one is main memory. Okay, so as I said, CPU is the brain of the memory. It has control over all the devices. It will control the input device, output device, and your main memory and auxiliary storage. Once you enter the data, it will go to the, it will save it in the main memory. From there, the arithmetic logic unit, right, that will take the control. It will process the data, and then finally, once it is processing data, it will send that process information to the main memory itself. From the main memory, the result will be displayed in the output unit. Okay, the auxiliary storage is nothing but your secondary storage unit, your hard disk, like that. Okay, let's see in the detail after this slide. So this is the two part. First one is hardware and the software. Any physical device to the computer is called the hardware, and the computer program, it is called as a software. Here there are different types of hardware. First one is input unit, CPU, we already seen in the flowchart itself. Storage, that is a primary storage. Auxiliary is a secondary storage, and last one is the output devices. Okay, I will give some examples for all these units. And the software is divided into four main parts. First one is system software, application software, utilities, and last one is the computer languages. Okay, moving on to the next, the examples for computer device. You all might know your touch screen, camera, mouse, keyboard, webcam, joystick, everything is, even the scanner. Scanner is the input device. And another examples also you can give, like your OMR sheets. OMR sheets used to mark the answers, right? That is also input device. If you go to the shop, you will have that barcode scanner, right? If you purchase any product, there will be a barcode. That barcode scanner also input device. Okay, next one is output device. Anything which displays the output, for example, in the speaker, you can able to hear the audio, right? That is the output device. And monitor, your CPU monitor, headphones, printer, where you will get the data printed in the paper, right? And projector and plotter. This is an example for output devices. The storage of the computer. Every information which you are storing in the computer will be in the form of bits. Bits means zeros and ones, binary digits. Okay, so if you enter a letter ABCD in the keyboard, it will not store as ABCD in the computer memory. It will be stored as a binary digits only, like zeros and ones. So eight bits, which is equal to 1 byte. So for representing one alphabet letter, for example A, you need 1 byte. That means 8 bits. Okay, and definition for word, word is like a group of bit which forms a which has a information in it, like data in it, which gives some basic information unit on the computer. It is called as a word. These are the basic terms in the computer memory. Please make note of it. There are different types of computer memory terms, which is called a kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, and terabyte. 1 kilobyte is equal to 1024 bytes. 1 megabyte, which is equal to 1024 kilobyte. 1 gigabyte, which is equal to 1024 megabyte, and 1 terabyte, which is equal to 1024 gigabyte. Okay. Seen in the first flowchart of the computer system, we have primary storage and auxiliary storage. So, in the what is primary storage? It is a input area where you can store the data and it can be processed the data. That is the use of primary storage. There are two different types of primary storage. One is RAM, another one is ROM. RAM means random access memories. Okay, it is used for both read and write memory. You can read. Read means whatever the information stored, you can read, and write means the output can be written in the memory. That is the thing. Okay, and it is a volatile memory. What is meant by volatile memory? Any information stored in the memory will get erased. It will get lost when the power supply goes off or interrupted. So it is not a permanent memory to store the information. This is the definition for RAM. And for ROM, read only memory. It is also built in memory of the computer, and it is a permanent memory. Even if it is even the power supply goes off, whatever written in the memory will be permanent. It will not erased. So until it is overwritten, if you write overwrite any information on that. And moving on to, we'll store the data temporarily, not as a permanent. So here comes the secondary memory, which is used for the bulk storage also. You can store the information in the secondary memory in the terms of gigabytes and terabytes also. There are two different types of secondary memory. One is the magnetic media, another one is the optic media. So magnetic media, examples are like hard disk, magnetic tapes, everything. It will hold a large amount of data which is stored in the computer. Okay, the second one is called the optical media. You will be using CDs, DVD drives. That is the optical media. It has certain limit only. It cannot store huge amount of information as like in the magnetic media. And another example for optic media is your flash, your pen drive, your memory card, memory stick also is the example for the optic media. And the next memory is called the cache memory. In this cache memory, it is a small memory unit, okay, which is work faster than the primary memory. And we all know that whatever information we give to the computer will be stored in the primary memory, right? So in that primary memory, you will have the small unit called cache memory, which will store the recently used values. This cache term you will be hearing in the web browser also. You will have cache memory. So recently used item will be saved in the cache memory, which can be accessed faster. That is the purpose of cache memory. Now if you go to your computer properties, my computer properties, you can access that using a control panel and the system under the system tab. The information displayed in this is a basic information about your computer. Here you can see what is the OS installed in your computer, that is Windows 10, and under the system you can see the processor. Processor means your CPU. What kind of processor, which generation processor? Mine is i5, and how much speed it can process the information. So 1.70 gigahertz to 2.40, that is the speed of the information process in your computer. Gigahertz, that is the speed referred in the computer processing. And second one is like RAM. If you see random access memory, my storage is like 8 GB. The higher the RAM, your computer speed will be more, because if you have a larger memory of RAM, you can store more data and it will process very fast. If you take 4 GB RAM computer, it will be little slower than the 8 GB RAM. Okay, and next one is system type. 64-bit operating system. See, every system will be like 32-bit or 64-bit. It means like type of word it will take for the processing. We saw the term called word and bit in the slide, right? This is how. Now you understand this particular technical term which is shown in the My Computer. Please go to your computer and check what is the RAM memory, system time memory, processor also. To the next topic called the software. Software is divided. The definition of software is a set of computer programs which is used to effective operation of the computer system. Okay. It is divided into four different parts. One is the system software, application software, utilities, and the computer language. First, we will see the system software. Okay. Definition for system software, it is one or more program. It is basically designed to control the operation of your computer system. For better understanding, like there are four different types of system software. One is the operating system, assembler, compiler, and interpreter. Operating system is OS. It is a master program which runs on the computer, which controls everything in your computer, like CPU, input, output system. Everything will be controlled under the operating system. Okay, for example, for that is Windows, Unix system. And second one is like assembler. This assembler, it is a program which translates the assembly language into the machine language program. It's all definitions. Once you're getting into the coding part, you will understand clearly. As of now, you just make a note of the definitions for this. And compiler, which is used to, it is also a translator, high level program into the machine language. Okay. And the last one is interpreter. This is a program which also convert the high level program into the machine codes and execute it. That's it. Once you learn the C, C++ languages, you will completely understand this as under assembler, compiler, and interpreter. That we will see in the different class. No worries. And moving on to the application software. See, this application software, it is a computer program. It is a program. What is program? Program is a set of instructions which you give to the computer to perform the particular task. Okay. This is also certain type of works can be done in the application software. For examples, you have Microsoft Word, which is used to type the document and spreadsheets, even your calculator. Everything will come under the application software. Okay. The next one is moving on to utilities. Utilities is basically used for maintenance of your computer, any maintenance works. If there is any system, there should be maintenance work, right? For example, your file management, how you divide the portion, the hard disk, that kind of works, and your virus, you will be using the antivirus program, right? That is also come under the utilities. Okay. And the encryption decryption tools, these are the examples for your utility program. And the last one is called the computer languages. If you want to develop any software, you need the computer language, that is a programming language used to develop the computer software. Okay, it has certain set of rules. Each program will have certain set of rules, that is called the syntax. And here in the computer language also, there is a three different types. One is machine language. It is also known as the low level language, assembly language, and third one is the high level language. In machine language, each instructions what you give, it will be in the form of zeros and ones. It will be easily understand by the computer, but as a human being, it is very difficult to write the program in zeros and ones. So we will not use this machine level language in our day-to-day activities. And next comes the next evaluation. There is a upgradation is like assembly language. It is also can be written in the English language. It is much easier to write than the machine language. Okay. And the third one is called the high level language. This language is used to write the program in the high level English language. For example, for those high level languages are C++, your C++ program, Java program, Python, everything comes under the high level language. These are the code. Any program written in the high level language is called the source code. object code. If any high level language is converted into the machine language, zeros and ones, it is called the object code. Okay, next topic is operating system. This is a software which is used, as I told you earlier, it is control the computer. It will be serving as an interface between the computer and the user. The example for the operating system is Word, Linux, Mac, and Unix. This is the basic of operating system. Moving on to the chapter called the word processor, that is MS Word. I have given some practice time example. You might have learned the basics of word processor. So we will start with some exercise. This is a passage I have given, paragraph I have given, types of operating system. Now go to your Word document, open new Word document. Type this paragraph, like from the types of operating system till the distributed last paragraph, and then save your Word document as exercise 1. Create a new folder called MS Word. Under that, you save it. You're done with the typing of the document. First thing, you have to make the heading as a bold, and the size will be 18, and the font will be comic. The paragraph, like under the heading, there is a paragraph that should be font should be Arial and 14 size. You have to highlight your main words, any words which you find as the main words, in the color, any color. You should use the highlight text color, and you should apply border to the page. You should set the margin to the narrow, and each paragraph line should be given with the spacing of 1.5. Do all these steps and save your document under the folder which I shown. If you have any doubt, please contact me. Thank you. Bye.